Hey guys, it is I am back again with another video. So clearly I'm back from my cruise. It was fantastic. I'm rude. I just jumped right into it. I didn't even just like do any intro. My name is Kathy. For those who are looking at this video for the first time, my channel is Kathy Cruises. Hello. Thank you for watching. For those who've been around for a long time, again, I thank you, I thank you, I thank you. You've been leaving me some really beautiful comments and I am so very, very grateful, okay? Tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to check me out. Like and subscribe if I'm saying something, doing something, or I just make your day, because I'm probably gonna do it again at some other time. So it would be great if you just subscribe so I can get these numbers up so that I can take this channel to new heights and live the purpose that I feel I want to live. Okay, enough of that. I am back from my cruise. I went on a 4-day, 3-night cruise on the Carnival Liberty, which ported out of Port Canaveral, and we sailed to Bimini, the Bahamas. Amazing, guys. Bimini is, I guess, what Tulum was before it became overrun with tourists. I've been to Tulum. It's still beautiful. It's still magical. I absolutely love Tulum, but I'm sure Bimini is what Tulum used to be. Bimini was laid back, it was quiet, it's small, and I just had an absolutely fantastic time. If you're looking to just relax and kind of chill, Bimini is perfect. It has a different energy than Nassau or even Freeport. It's laid back, it's real chill. I'm not sure how much fun children would have because I didn't see a whole lot for children to do. But if you are an adult that just wants some R&R, Bimini is where you would really want to go. I ate conch for the first time, which is amazing. I want to go back to Bimini just for the cracked conch. Now, yeah, I could have had conch in Nassau. I don't know why I never had it. Because I've been to Nassau several times. I don't know why I never had it, but I never had it. It was delicious. I had a wonderful time off the ship and on the ship. And I guess that means that I'm cruising. I'm back to cruising, baby. I don't know when I'm going to do it again, but I'm back. So I want to talk to you guys about just a few of my Amazon favorites when I travel. Things that I've recently bought that I actually used or I'm getting ready to use because I'm getting ready to go on another trip. I told you guys I'm going to Jamaica next week. So I'm assembling stuff. I was going to do a pack with me, but I don't think I'm going to do that because pack with me's are not that fun for me to do, to be honest. They're not. They're time consuming and I just don't really know how to do them and make them super interesting in my opinion. I like watching other people's depending on how they do them. Again, it's a matter of how you do them. And my editing skills, we working on that. We working on that. So I don't think I'm going to do a pack with me. I decided that I would just do some Amazon travel favorites that were beneficial to me, and maybe they'll be beneficial to you. So to start with, let's use what's in my hand. Y'all, I finally got a remote. I finally got a Bluetooth remote so that I can stop videos appropriately. So this is the first thing I have. It comes on a little lanyard and you can use it for iPhones or Android because I record my videos on my iPhone. Eventually, if I get better, I will invest in a camera, but for right now, this works for me. So the next thing, and these things just came in today, not the remote, but some of the things that I'm showing you. More packing cubes. These are the slim packing cubes. They literally cover my face. They literally, they fit really, really well in under the seat bags and carry-on bags because they take up the vertical space, which I think when you're packing, vertical space is a lot more efficient than trying to go horizontal. So I bought some more of these because the intention was that I was doing under the seat bag only because I'm only allowed a personal item for the tickets that I purchased. I don't think that's gonna work. I just don't. I am no longer, as I said, a minimal packer. I have tried. I think I'm gonna be overloaded with bags if I try to do under the seat. They're gonna be heavy and cumbersome. And I'm gonna have my daughter with me and I need to have hands on with her at all times. And I don't wanna stress about it. So I think I am gonna have to check a bag. So all of my personal item packing, I'm unpacking, and I'm just gonna use this one big suitcase. It's really big. I didn't get this from Amazon. It's a cow pack, but I really do like it because I like the print. So this is it. I just wanted to let you see it. Okay, so the next thing, I bought these little, it comes in a two pack, and they hold your oral care needs. I talked about them and I probably even showed it in my last video, but this is an up close of it. It has a hole at the top so moisture can escape, and it holds my toothbrush and a travel size toothpaste. And I also have some oral care picks, but I don't know where they are. I'll put them in before next week. The next thing is a extension cord with, I was trying to make sure that I got the right one. I needed one that could use regular plugs, but also USB A and C. I kind of hate that it only has one USB-C plug, because so many things are USB-C now, but I didn't see any that had more than one. And it has a pretty long extension cord because I found that when I was on the cruise ship, I took a something that plugged. I showed you the thing that I brought. That doesn't work for me to travel. Number one, it's a little unstable. It kept tipping. And then number two, it didn't have a long enough cord. So it literally had to stay like a few feet away from the source where you plugged it in at. That's not gonna work for me. This will work for me. The next thing, okay. This was not a necessity, but I use this in my everyday life. I have an iPhone, but I don't like AirPods. They hurt my ears because of the shape of my ears. So I always use a different type of earbud. I was using Amazon Echo earbuds, but I gave them to my son because something went wrong with his AirPods. So I did a little research and I came across these JLab ones. Okay, I came across these. And what I really liked about these a lot is that it is the skin tone collection. I think that's what they call it. They have several types that you can choose according to the shade of your skin, which I think is lovely, because the AirPods, that white piece is sticking out of your skin. Nobody's skin is that color. And maybe it doesn't matter to you, but until I saw this, it didn't matter to me either, other than the fact that I always hated white earbuds. So this is the shade that is closest to my shade. See? And it has its own charging plug. It has its own charging plug in there. So I don't even have to worry about having a cord. It comes in there. I don't want to open it because if I open it, it's going to be connected to the phone automatically. So yeah, they're great. I've really been enjoying them. I use them every day when I want to talk or listen to music while I'm out, and I will be carrying them to save space, I think. I'm not sure. Wait. Okay, so the next thing, oh y'all, I cannot wait to use this. So this is like in the style of the bandolier cell phone wallet type holders. I don't want to spend $90 for a actual bandolier because I am not going to use that every day because I carry a purse every day. But for travel, this is amazing. And I can't stand up because, well, I'm going to stand up. Okay. Look. So cool, right? Okay. So this is what I'm going to have when I'm just moving about so that my hands are free. I typically don't carry a purse when I travel at all. I might have a evening purse, like to go to dinner. And unless I'm going somewhere fancy or like I'm with my friends, like I was on the cruise, I don't bring clutches and I'm not bringing any type of purse. So I got this. This can hold, it's a change purse, but it can hold whatever you want. I'm probably going to put my earbuds in there. This part holds your phone. And then, okay, don't act up now just because we on camera. And this thing is acting like it does not want to open. It's like a little change purse. I'm going to have to work on this. But it also opens, and you can keep your ID, your credit cards, all that other kind of stuff. And it has a magnetic closure. I'm gonna do something. I'm gonna put something on this zipper so that we can open it, because then you can put bills and stuff. And I think the reviews on this said that the zipper was hard to open. Okay, I got it open. I'm not gonna close it. But you can put stuff in there. I'm gonna put something on here to make it easier to go. But that's gonna be I haven't used it yet, but I'm going to use that. So the next thing is I take my iPad when I travel. So if I don't like what's on TV, because I typically watch TV before I go to bed at night. And it doesn't matter where I am, whether I'm on a cruise ship, whether I'm in a hotel room, if I'm home, I watch a little TV and then either I set a timer or I just turn it off when I've had enough. So I'm going to bring my iPad. I brought my iPad on the cruise ship and forgot that I didn't have anything to make sure it was protected. I was just using a transparent backing on it, and I don't like that. So I bought a iPad holder, and it's red because my laptop is red. Like, I got this red thing going on. I'll show y'all eventually. But it has a sleep wake feature. This holds it secure when the iPad is in there and you want to watch a movie or something, you'll take it here and there you go. You got your, yeah. So this will be coming with me. I didn't have it for the cruise, but I have it now. I also bought another belt bag, fanny pack, whatever y'all want to call it. They've been around for a while. The new term is belt bag. Fanny pack, a lot of people don't like because it sounds so antiquated and something that your grandmother would carry. Well, I am somebody's grandmother, and this is stylish, so I don't have a problem with it. It's faux leather. I do not have any fanny packs in this color, which is why I bought one. Everything, I have a habit of buying everything black because black goes with everything. And while it does, sometimes black is a little harsh if you're wearing lighter colors. So this is the answer to that. I didn't want beige. I didn't want white because I'm not a white type person for bags. It's going to get dirty. It has a zipper at the back. So when it's close to your body, that's protected. And you can put in there whatever you want to put in there. I just have a little card case in there that I'll eventually fill up. And then here's the opening. And it's fairly wide. Like, you can get your phone in here if you want. I have our passports in here because I like to keep those close to me. I don't really like them in a bag. I want them with me, on me, a part of me, because we all know what happens if you lose your passport. You can't get home on time. You will eventually get there, but it may not be when you originally planned on it. So my belt bag is coming with me. And then I think I only have one more thing. And that's why I said I wasn't really sure. Over-the-ear headphones. I don't really like earbuds for long periods of time. I get ear fatigue. They start to aggravate me and they hurt. So I just found an inexpensive pair of over-the-ear headphones. Those suit me the best. And it came with a case. And I need things with cases. And I really love it. They're foldable. The sound is great. And I don't think they're noise canceling. They might be, but they're not like intense noise canceling. So, but they do the job for me. When I'm traveling with the kids, I don't really want anything that's truly noise canceling, because I need to hear what's going on around me. I need to hear what they're doing or whatever. So I'm okay with the level of noise canceling that they offer. I'm more concerned about comfort and the sound. And it comes with an aux cord just in case you want to take advantage of the airline's entertainment. And you know, if you're using that, you have to plug it directly into the seat back where they have the screen, unless they're doing it solely on your own personal device. And if you have Bluetooth headphones, and these are Bluetooth, however, they have the aux cord that if I needed to plug it into something else, I could also do that. And I don't remember how much they were. I will link these things below. Y'all know that I'm so bad about linking things, but I think that they're great products. So I want you to be able to take advantage of them. So I will link them below and you will see the cost of what they are. And that's pretty much it. I have other stuff because I've been shopping. But right now I'm trying to figure out where everything is. I don't know if I've packed some of this stuff already or I'm actively using them, because they are things that while I travel with them, I also use them in my day-to-day life. That might be what the problem is, why I can't find them. But I feel like these few things will get you started and help you to be able to travel more efficiently and happier as a nomad, a wanderer, of a traveler of the world. Y'all pay me no mind. So I'm gonna go. I am not going to drag this out, because I'll be back again with probably some daily vlogs from Negril, Jamaica, baby. So I'm going to go, but thank you all for your continued presence and your support. And I will see you in the very next one. Bye. Why isn't it stopping? I don't know.